You are watching One Book, One Review with Wiebke.
Hey everyone, let's talk about The Sea by John Banville. This book won the Man Booker Award and it definitely deserves it. It's not very long, but there's a lot of information in it, there's a lot of story in it, and it's amazing. The Sea basically tells the story of Max Morden, who just lost his wife and is a little bit lost. And being a little bit lost gets him back to a place where he used to go as a child for holidays with his parents. And he stays at the Cedars and remembers his past. And that's what this is. We have this man telling us about his life, basically his first love and his last love and the events connected to both of these situations. Now that might not sound very exciting, but the way he tells it is sort of like stream of consciousness. He flows in time between now, past, different now, and it's all flowing into each other. It's very well done that you really have to see what's the past, what's now, and the changes are subtle and sometimes really blunt. And I really enjoyed that you really had to pay attention. It's like, when is that now? And who are the characters we're talking about now? But it also made sense the whole time, the changes between the times. The writing itself is very beautiful. The words he uses are not words I've read in a long time or ever. There were some words where I wished I had a dictionary right there next to me just to look them up to be sure what they meant. It's not that I couldn't understand them from the context, but they were not common words or frequent words that you read everywhere. And I really like that because it gave his language a more beautiful, more picturesque feel. And through his beautiful writing and choice of words, he conveyed everything. The scenery, the characters, the feelings, and also the troubles with the feelings. And also the concept of memory, because that is a question for him. He sometimes thinks like, why do I remember this? It doesn't seem to make any sense. And he gives us his memory in a frayed way that memory sometimes is, illogical and out of context. Reading this short book told me a lot about this character and about his life and also about how he sees the world and how he wants to be. This is a big topic for him, like, who am I? And who am I now that my wife is dead? And what do I do now? Before I say amazing again, let me stop here. This novel is worth reading, not only for the writing alone, but also for the topic of love and loss. And I can just recommend it to anyone who wants to get into literary fiction, who is into literary fiction, and who wants to read something that is just beautiful. As usual, if you've read The Sea, tell me in comments. If you've read anything else by John Banville that you think I should read next, tell me in comments. If you haven't read it, just pick it up. Let me know what you think. Bye-bye.